Hello and welcome to the Art Gallery Workshop. I'm your host, Christopher Epling. I'd like to thank the Holler and Pack TV for making this program possible. Today we're going to be looking at a couple of things regarding my work. But before we do that, I'd like to showcase something that was sent in to me. And it's stellar, amazing work done by a local artist over in Belfry High School to be exact. And what we have here, the author and illustrator of this graphic novel is Chrissy Walters. Chrissy has put together an amazing story. I was blown away by her use of panels and her artwork. So if you open up the actual book here, you can see that she has done everything proper. She has used absolutely every technique, tip, scale, that you can pull together as a young artist. And what we've went over in the workshop, she has done it. Absolutely terrific job. The storyline is amazing. Her artwork is unique and well put together. She used the Marvel method to create her characters. Each character has their own background, story, and each character is just wonderfully designed and created. This is what I want to encourage everyone to do. I want everyone to participate. If you have artwork that you'd like to send in to us here at the Art Gallery Workshop, please do that. You can submit those on theholler.org. That's probably the best way to do it, to share your work so everybody sees it. I'll be more than happy to share that on here on a program. So please, by all means, if you're interested in sharing and creating just like Chrissy did, send in your work. This is what the workshop's about. It's not about me and what I've done or what I can do or my capabilities and limitations. It's about you, the artist out there in our community, in our region, in our county. It's about showcasing what you come up with. Now, what we're going to do today is going to be a little different on in terms of what we've done in the past. We're actually going to be looking at me as an artist in terms of why am I qualified, or qualified, I guess, to actually be teaching, what qualifications I have, what I've done. You know, one thing that I always try to do when you're listening to someone, if you see someone putting out information, you always want to say, hey, are they qualified, or where are they coming from? How do they know what they're saying? Can I trust what they're saying is accurate? And so today we're going to be talking about that a little bit. Now, I grew up here in Pike County, up near Elkhorn City. I live here. I moved back about 3 years ago. I served in the United States military. I'm a graduate of the University of Pikeville and the University of Kentucky. And while at UK, I started drawing for the student newspaper. That's how a lot of this happened. Since then, I've visited schools. I visited over 300 schools in state, every school in Pike County, schools in Tennessee, Ohio, Virginia, West Virginia. I go to a lot of schools, and I conduct the Art Gallery Workshop, the Sequential Art Workshop, which deals a lot with what we're talking about in here, combining creative writing and the visual arts to tell a story. So we're building on these concepts and techniques with the Art Gallery Workshop. So if you follow along, you're following along basically with what we do in the schools with these workshops, okay? So I really want to share with you today a little bit about my work, and we're going to start out by talking a little bit about my books, my publications. The first book that came out was in 2012, and it's Irby's Turn to Rake. Now, this was featured on a few television shows. The media picked up on this and covered it very well, and I really appreciated that. This won a Silver Star for Reader's Children's Book of the Year from Reader's Favorite, and for 4th to 6th grade reading level. This book was, like I said, published in 2012, featured at the Kentucky Book Fair, received 5 out of 5 stars from Reader's Favorite as well. It's a picture book / chapter book written in rhyme. I'm the author and the illustrator to this title. So when the comics happened, first I thought, well, comics are fun. I like to draw. And then this book was published. I said, well, hey, I really like to do illustrations. This is an interesting career. I never thought it would be anything possible that I could work in this field, but you can. And that's the biggest thing I want to share with you. If you draw, if you're an artist, and you don't have to work for Marvel, DC, Pixar, the big corporations in order to have a career in this field. You don't. Okay. The second book that I wrote and illustrated is this little book. Now, this book is a unique book. One of my favorite artists is Edward Gorey. He passed away in 2000. He was a children's book author in the 70s and late 60s. He wrote a lot of children's books that were cross-hatched in pen and ink. So if you were to open this book up, you'll notice that this book is designed after Edward Gorey's own creation. So you can see here the illustrations are black and white. They're in pen and ink. And this is a true story. This book was created for the Mosby Foundation. It's about a dog that I adopted from the Jessamine County Animal Shelter. Her name's Bella. She has Addison's disease. Now, Addison's disease is a rare disorder in canines. And the Mosby Foundation assists people who can't afford health care to provide health care for their pets. So it also brings awareness of Addison's disease. Now, another book that I wrote and illustrated, I don't have a copy here, but you can visit www.saltwebcomic.com, S-A-L-T, webcomic.com. I have an example later I'll show you, but that is a faith-based webcomic. I'm a Christian, and I noticed when I started looking at webcomics, there wasn't a lot of webcomics for young Christians, so I created a website that is spiritual themed, and it's for young Christians to check out. So if that's interested you at all, please do check that out. Now, I've also not just written and illustrated my own books. I've illustrated books for other people. This is There Shall I Be from Matt Miller. Now, this title was Mark's second book. This came out in 2014. He's a Kentucky author. So there's about 15 black and white pen and ink drawings in this book. His first book, Neighboring, came out in 2013. Now, this book is also short stories from Kentucky. So this is about, again, has about 12 to 15 black and white illustrations in it. Another book that I illustrated is Owen Owl's Wise Words. Now this was written by Melinda and Julia Richardson. They are also Kentucky authors. This book is 34 pages long, and it's about bird beak adaptation. So it has an educational-based side to it. Another book that I don't have a copy here with me today, but if you look behind me, it's Simon Salamander. It was written by Mary Powell Wagner. She's a Kentucky author. And I'm also working on four books right now, which I have examples from some of them today for other various publishers. One's in St. Augustine, Florida. One's from over in Virginia. And then there's three more that I'm working for here in Kentucky. I would like to share with you another great example. This has been shown on the media a lot. There was a WYMT newscast done on Ted's book. Ted Hudson is a junior in Breathitt County. He wrote and illustrated his adaptation of Noah's Ark. Now, he worked on this book prior to me going to Breathitt County, but I went and I spent a week over there helping Ted and working with him, and we got his book together, and now he's a published author. You could go to www.tedhudson.net. His book's available all over the world. He has his own e-commerce site, and he's saving up for college. And Ted also, and I have permission from his family and the school to share this, he has a mild form of autism, but his abilities and capabilities are absolutely brilliant. He's amazing. So he's overcome a lot, and you know what? Ted's well on his way to becoming a very successful published author and illustrator. Now, when you think of illustration as a whole, sometimes we don't really think about all the different ways you can apply art as a career. How do you make money? There's one thing to sit down and draw and paint and do comics, but how do you turn this into a source of revenue or a job? Well, you have to do the work. You have to put yourself out there and make yourself available. You have to have examples to show people. I've done a lot of work for various companies and businesses and tourism departments, and I've brought examples to show you today. Here's one, and these are local examples. This is from the Hillbilly Days. I think this is 2014 here. So I did the Hillbilly Day t-shirt design. And again, these are all local designs here that I've chose for you to share with you. This one was created in 2014. Also have another one here. This is the Hatfield McCoy Day t-shirt. This was a pretty big hit. It's sort of funny. You have the two patriarchs there of the families, and they're arguing over one of the balloon shootout games because they brought their own raffles. So this is a great example here to show you how illustration can be incorporated into different career-based things. And I've also brought some examples I'd like to pull up on the screen and show you. What I'm about to show you here are a couple of variations of things. We have different examples from children's books. We have examples from illustration-based type jobs and things. So I'm going to go ahead and pull this up on the screen, and I'll kind of talk you through this and let you and get an idea of what this is. Now, this first image we have is an image from Owen Al's Wise Words. This book, again, Melinda and Julia Richardson are the authors to this book. As you can see, the book has a lot of color in this story. This book was completed using watercolor, colored pencil, and some digital. So if you look here on the bird's feathers here, like in this area, you see the mouse on the screen, and also here the deep blues and the oranges, those are all digital art. Now this is from Mary Powell Wagner's new book. It's called Dance of the Firefly. I'm actually just finished this book. This isn't even published yet. When you work as an illustrator, there's tons of different opportunities for local regional publishing companies. They always seek authors. Now this is a pretty interesting sketch. This is for an author. Her name is Jane Quackenbush. She's from St. Augustine, Florida. She's the author of the Pirate Ship Bed Trip, and also the Rocket Ship Bed Trip series. And so we have some character sketches from that. Here's the bunny, actually from the series, the Rocket Ship Bed Trip. We go on now to take a look at, this is work done for bluegrass.org. That's in Lexington. This is an actual little tea shop that caters to families. They bring their children in. They have different characters, Disney characters dressed up and things, and various other things to entertain the kids. Here's another one from the small tea shop there in Lexington. Now how they use these, they put these on magnets and t-shirts and all that other stuff. So we'll be able to take a look at that too here in a second. We're going to actually go back through here. I'm going to show you from the beginning a couple more. See if we can actually pull this up. Not sure why. Now this one here is actually from an author's book called Holding the Light, Abby Combs. This is an illustration from her new book that's coming out. Here's the keychains. It's kind of a blurry picture, but you can see how the illustrations are used. They also have put these on bears and other types of merchandise there in the store. One local example I'd like to share with you, kind of going a little bit more in depth on this one than others. I do some work for Pikeville Tourism. They have the White Lightning zip line that's, you know, everyone's really excited about. It's a big hit. It's really been popular. All, you know, people from all over the region come in to check it out and look at it and participate. And Pikeville Tourism commissioned me for the White Lightning zip line map. Now, what this map serves to do is orientate those visiting Bob Amos and the different attractions there around Bob Amos Park, where they are and what surround them. And Pikeville Tourism expressed that they would like to have something done that's similar to the cartoon walkthrough maps that you see sometimes in different parks and things of that nature. Now, if you look really close on this map, there's tons of really funny and interesting things. Now, yes, this is hillbilly themed. But like I said in a previous workshop, you know, we can appreciate our heritage. We don't have to glorify stereotypes, but you know what? It's fun to remember that you know, some folks have a certain perception about us, and that's okay if they do. We're going to have fun right along with them. So here we have the overlook. This is looking over. I think that's pretty. It's pretty funny. You want to play on words and things in these situations. You have a little band over here playing some bluegrass. You have the University of Pikeville bear, and he's trying to make sense between the pig and the penguin, playing a little soccer. And here's the RV park we have. Over here we have the puppy park. I also have a little guy here who's getting ready to play baseball with a golf club. I stuck myself in this drawing by the YMCA. See, I poke fun at myself. It's all fun. And here we have a guy getting ready to play baseball, and the chicken don't look too happy about that. Up here at the top we have a typical steel and the White Lightning zip line leading into where their the building is, where you go to sign up and participate. Looks like he's in a little bit of trouble, and I guess you can kind of figure out why there too. So this map, it's fun, but it's also informative. Over here's the horse park. You can see little guy sitting on the back of the horse here, and there's with the horse stables. And then you have the map legend, and the map legend shows you where everything is. So you have the trails going around the park, and then each little tiny cartoon represents a different aspect of Bob Amos and the White Lightning Zipline attractions there. So if you work as an illustrator, you don't always have to just do children's books. You work for all sorts of different things, companies, tourism departments, individuals. I've worked for real estate companies drawing houses that they list, doing portraits, house portraits. I've worked for symphonies, candy companies, publishing companies, creating logos. So if you want to visit my website, there's a lot more on my portfolio. Okay. Now, another aspect to my work is the comics. So you have the illustration here, and then on the other side, you have the comics and things. When I won the Kentucky Press Association Mark of Excellence Award, it was back-to-back years while at UK. It was 2013 and 2012-2013. That really prompted a lot of folks to start requesting my work. And a lot of newspapers started requesting my work, and that led into a lot of opportunities to share my work with people from all over the region, state, and one of the things that I wanted to do with that kind of opportunity, I wanted to not do comics. Now, when you say comics, a lot of people have a misconception. We're not talking about Spider-Man, Batman, and Charlie Brown. Comics can mean a lot of different things. Basically, you have drawings with words to tell a story. Now, that could be anything, okay? And I'll show you a few examples of actually what I've done to create that. Now, the first one I'm going to show you is actually a legend out of Breathitt County. And this is the legend of Bad Tom Smith. Now, this is the actual artwork for this. Bad Tom Smith killed six people back in the 1890s. And during that time period, that was considered a heinous act. Now, it fails in comparison to some of the crazy things going on in the world. But back then, you know, shooting six people, that was pretty bad stuff. So this is tied to our region in a way. This was published in Modern Mountain Magazine. So here's the magazine here, talking about the breaks. This was fall 2014, and if you were to open up the book, you've got the comic that is printed inside here. Bad Tom Smith was sentenced to be hung to death for his crimes in Breathitt County, and he also tried to get out of being hung to death and did everything he could to do that. Now, here's one that's a little more close to home. The Lexington Herald asked me to talk about the SOAR Summit. You remember that there was a summit here talking and concerning the future of Appalachia. And they gave me one rule with that. They said, we don't want you to talk about coal. Now, I didn't really agree with that. I guess they were wanting me to become inventive, but I did manage to work in coal in a way. And here's the actual cartoon that appeared in the Lexington Herald here. And you notice there's words and it's in color here. This comic also appeared in the Modern Mountain Magazine. So you can see that there's multiple places and publications that print your work. Just one comic can be printed over and over and over. But I want to talk about this comic for a second, because this one's it's really important to me, especially, okay? Now, this is a great example on how you can use comics to make a point that doesn't involve superheroes, things of that nature. So if we look close at this comic, you can see here. First, we have me and my grandfather. We're in the first panel, and he's telling me, if you could read the words, you could see it. But he's telling me what a great opportunity it is to be able to draw for the Lexington Herald and work with Joel Pett and those guys. And then I ask him, you know, what should I draw about, Grandpa? And like I said, the words, you know, appeared here in the paper, but that's put in digitally. Well, my grandfather goes on to tell me that, you know, you could start off by telling him that not everybody back here in the mountains are running to the pharmacies and taking drugs to get high, or not all of us go to crooked lawyers in order to help us take advantage of the system on welfare. And while we appreciate our heritage, we don't appreciate those who glorify stereotypes. And he goes on to say, we have vast potential as a region. He talks about the hardworking people that carved out a living here in an area where most wouldn't have been able to make it. Now, although they said not to use mining, I worked it in. He holds up a picture of a miner, and he says in this caption, God knows we've all seen our share of hard times. And then he goes on to talk about how if the EPA restrictions continue and policies continue, we're going to see hardworking families leaving our region looking for jobs. And at the end, my grandfather turns to me and says, What about the economy? Do you have any ideas on how we could boost it? Now, this is a comic, so I did end with a punchline. At the bottom, I say, well, I was going to suggest faking a Bigfoot sighting. Yeah, okay, it's not really funny, but so this is a great example, though, on how you can use comics to show a certain idea, theme, or point. Now, here's one on superstitions. I'll go ahead and flip this over so you can get a better idea of this here. This is on superstitions in the mountains. And what this is, it deals with Christmas time. Now, back in the day, there were tons of superstitions in the mountains. One of those was surrounding a Christmas. And around Christmas, some of the beliefs were here. So here we have past generations in Eastern Kentucky held a lot of surprising superstitions concerning Christmas. See, there's me with my hat and my dog beside me. Now, this is an interesting one. On Christmas Eve at midnight, people believe that animals could talk. They kneel in observance of Christ's birth and they could talk. And here's a good one for some of you females who are getting of marrying age. They believe that if you went out to the pig pen on New Year's, on Christmas Eve, that if an old pig grunted at you, you're going to be very unhappy in your marriage. If a younger pig grunted at you, then you're in good shape. They believe that anything baked on Christmas Eve had healing powers. They even believed that if you put your ear up to a beehive, you could hear the bees inside humming from the Book of Psalms. And then another thing was, if you stood underneath a pine tree and you heard the sound of angels singing, didn't mean you had very long to live. Now, this one confused me because I'm not sure. I'm not really good on entomology. I guess that's the study of bugs. But I think bees hibernate. I don't think they're even in their hive. Okay, here's another example. This one is from Wolf Pit. That's a little community that I grew up on in Wolf Pit. Now, this comic has no words in it. This is also Modern Mountain Magazine. The title of this comic even is called Wolf Pit Branch Road. And this one deals with a widow. It's a serious topic. There's not a lot funny to this. It goes through the daily routine of a widow here. And here we have a young girl. She's bringing what looks to be a bag up to the door. And here you can see the van parked out the lady's home. She walks up. She hands the lady her food from the Senior Citizen Center. Okay, down here we have the lady walking out to her van after she delivers the meal. And then we're going to jump over here to the lady walking by a picture. And in the picture we can see her and another gentleman, must be her husband. And she's outside and she's watering her plants on her porch. And then we see a gentleman start to walk up the walk. We see from here it's a mail carrier. She sits down inside. She opens up the letter here. You can see the cupcake near her bag of food, and it says Happy Birthday, Granny. And here it's a card she got. You notice the correlation here, the flowers are the same as what's on the porch. So, and you go down a little bit and you can notice more cards on the mantle here for her birthday. And then we see the close-up of this picture, which must be her late husband. She's sitting in the living room looking at the phone, which apparently doesn't ring. If you look out the window here, you can actually see something in the tree. And then here we see what it is. It's a bird's nest. And it's a mother bird who's feeding her babies. And if you think about the correlation between a grandmother and the motherly figure here of the bird, you know, that's meant to bring in emotions, okay? So here we have her display for her evening meal, her cupcake, her milk, her food, and she's watching Wheel of Fortune, okay, with a candle and her cupcake. So this is a great example how comics can be used to share this kind of thought. Now, this one's a little bit more political than the others. My grandfather ran a store up near Marrowbone for a very long time, Johnson's Store. And it was a small, he's still there, he's still working in that store every day. But small mom and pop shops have really changed a lot. And we know why now. Here we have, back in the day, we have our church, and the church is filled with people have a revival, farming, wildlife, fishing. We have a couple here who's making baskets, quilting, little boy fishing. We got the chickens. We got the folks here playing music. Then we go here to the store. It says out of business. Down here we have a man standing outside looking at it. We go down a little bit further. We see the church here. Notice no one's really there. The cemetery's filling up. He's putting a revival up, but no one's there. We got the little guy on the four-wheeler jumping over. Then we see the coal, which makes everything possible in our economy, in our region. And then down below, though, we see where all of our money's going, which is here, Walmart. Now, you can argue one way or the other. Walmart's a great place for us. It holds all the things we need in one area. But the one disadvantage of putting all of our eggs in one basket, we see these mom-and-pop stores closing left and right. So comics is a way to express that. You may not agree with this point, but that's okay. It's a format to express these kind of things, okay? I have a couple more examples that I'd like to share with you actually on the screen. And at the end of all this, we're going to draw something themed and connected to everything we've talked about. It will be a quick sketch. There will be some drawing during the art gallery workshop, believe it or not, today. We're going to be drawing a mascot for UPike. We're going to be doing the bear themed under what we've been talking about here today, okay? All right, so I do want to share with you up here on the screen. This is actually one of the Salt comics I promised to show you. If you could go to www.saltwebcomic.com. And again, if anything today's inspired you, let's say you don't agree with the Walmart statement, then create a comic, send it in, and I will share your point of view. I would be more than happy to. I want to see your work. So here we have an older lady, and this is her grandson. And this is faith-based. So she says, "I need to go see the pasture." In the next panel, we have the little guy saying, "Nana, Nell, do you mean go see the pastor?" And she says, "Well, that's what I said, the pasture." And he thinks about it for a second. He goes, okay, I see. And then he noticed they're in the car driving. He goes, "So, Nana, what do you need to go see the pasture for?" And she says, "Well, I need him to pray over my tooth that's hurting." And at the end panel, you see her standing in a field in front of a pasture. And she says to him, "Honey, I said take me to the pasture. Why did you take me to the dentist instead?" So that's from the Salt series. It's a little different, a little funny, I guess. Hopefully some of you find it funny. So today we focus primarily on everything dealing with me and my work and the workshops and kind of giving you an idea of why we're even here with the Art Gallery Workshop in the first place. And really what it boils down to is you, the viewer. And the things that I share with you today is just to give you an idea of why I'm here. But I want to see your work. It doesn't have to be from younger artists. Chrissy Walters from earlier, amazing job. I'm so happy she sent that in. But if you have artwork, let's say you're an artist my age, older, younger, it doesn't matter. If you're from Pike County or even the surrounding areas, the viewing areas, and you'd like to see your work showcased here, send it to me. Now, how you do that is you have to get online. You have to go to www.theholler.org. Once you go there, you have to find the Art Gallery Workshop, click on that, and then links to how to send me files and images and anything you have is right there readily available, okay? Now, this is kind of a fun segment, a little different. We're going to break it into two parts, actually. Next time, we're going to be talking a lot about drawing. We're going to be working on some things themed around some of the things you saw here today. I hope you've enjoyed this episode. I'd like to thank Pike TV for bringing this to you, the viewers, and also to The Holler for helping in production. I do want to encourage you, please log on to The Holler and .org and send me your work, okay? I really enjoy working with you, talking about these techniques and different types of approaches to art and illustration and comics. I hope you enjoy it too. Thank you so much for tuning in. I'll see you next time here on the Art Gallery Workshop. Thank you.